China and the US will resume trade talks later this month. And the talks on trade with Mexico are ongoing. Joining us now, the White House Council of Economic Affairs Chair, Kevin Hassett. Kevin, I know that you're not a trade guy. I understand that. But you got to talk to those guys. They're probably in the office next door. Of course, are we close to a trade deal of any kind?
Right. Well, you know, let's update everybody on the three things that are ongoing and in the news already. First, that there are Mexican talks going on that are very close to the finish line. In fact, Ambassador Lighthizer, who deserves some kind of medal for the long hours he's putting in, was meeting yesterday with folks. And, you know, some of us will be meeting even later today as well. And I think that we're very confident that most of our differences have been worked out there. With Europe, you know, that Mr. Juncker came here and had a great meeting with the president and set a charted a course forward for a deal with Europe that's going to be exactly what President Trump promises voters, a fully fair and reciprocal trade deal. And so now, you know, China has reached out with a sort of lower level official trying to maybe decompress things a little bit and start over again with the talks. And, we certainly have a lot of asks of China, but the fact that they've reached out and that they're sending someone over to meet with David Malpass is covered in the news. And it's, you know, a really good sign that the president's negotiating strategy is really working.
So we can leave it at this. Positive developments on trade talks. You comfortable with that?
Left and right.
And near a conclusion, with Mexico, right?
That's correct.
Hopeful with China, right?
Well, I mean, the China thing, I'm not going to step out in front of that. Again, I'm not the trade negotiator, but it's good news for everyone who's, charting a course to the president's ultimate objective of, zero tariffs and zero non-tariff barriers on our stuff so that our exports have access to the Chinese market. You know, I think the fact that they're coming back to talk is, it's a positive sign.
Okay. I'm going to chuck some red meat for you. You're going to like this. You're going to respond very favorably. And here it is. There's a study. It's from the Goodman Institute. And it found that most of the benefits of President Trump's tax reform are not going to the wealthy. No, they're spread around. Go at it, please.
Yeah, that's absolutely what we've been saying, back on your show in the fall. And, we took a lot of heat for that, for saying that productivity would go up, capital spending would go up, and ultimately wages would go up. If you look at the latest data, we just got productivity data that were the highest we've seen in a number of years. Capital spending is booming. And that stuff historically helps blue-collar workers because, you and I have got practically no productivity at all, right? But it's definitely the case that machines don't make us much more productive or affect our wage. But a typical blue-collar worker without a college degree, he's more productive if he has better machines to work with, and that guy's wage is going to go up because productivity is skyrocketing right now. And so, absolutely, the sort of benefit from the growth, the lower unemployment, and the capital formation is maximal for people who need capital to increase their productivity.
Hey.
Not nerds like me and you.
What, me and you? Me? Hey, I'm productive. I've got a three-hour live show here on the
Fox
Business
Network. It's true. And a lot of revenue from ads. It's true.
Yeah. So I'm told. This is the last one for you, Kevin. I know we're going to get another good response. New York Governor Andrew Cuomo said the U.S. was never great. Now, what do you say to that?
I'd have to look at the context to see if there was any possible thing around that he could say to make it defensible, but it's just not correct. In fact, the U.S. is great again. We've sure got work to do, but look at it. We're growing 4%. GDP now for the third quarter is north of 4%. Could you imagine if we get two quarters north of 4% in a row? That's a great economy. But if you think about the accomplishments of the greatest generation and so on, I think America's been great for a really long time.
Well, you could have pointed
out.
How about D-Day?
Got worse.
How about that? How about D-Day? How about the moonshot? How about
my uncle Burns' first deployment in World War II was reinforcements at Bastogne. And you can't tell me that Uncle Byrne wasn't great. He's a paratrooper. Come on, America's been great for a long time, but I think that we did lose connection a little bit with the things that made us great in the last few years. And President Trump has reconnected us to the idea that, free market capitalism is an engine of growth for everybody and that we need to stand up for ourselves in the international community and so on. And he's done that. And just look at the results. Look at what markets are doing. Look at what growth is doing. I think are we absolutely great again? Well, we've always been great, but we sure have improved a lot.
You could have pounded the table, Kevin. I mean, I know there's no table in front of you, but you really
could have raised your fist. There's a music stand here.
All right. I'll let you off the hook.
Yeah, but I don't know Cuomo. And, I mean, maybe he's a good guy. I don't know. Probably not.
Give you a shot right like there. That. I gave you the chance, Kevin. I opened up for you. Kevin Hassett, everyone. He's all
thank
right.
You.
Thanks for joining us, sir. We appreciate it.
Thank you. Thank you.